Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. PlayStation VR 2 release is just around the corner. We all waiting for it. So let's have a look at top 10 must-buy launch titles in my opinion. But of course, I gonna strongly encourage you to write your top 10 in the comment section if you don't agree with what I'm saying, but want to share it with other people. And we see what games you thinking about. But this is my list, and I'm starting from Star Wars: Tales from the Galaxy's Edge. And I'm doing this because, I play Star Wars Tales from the Galaxy's Edge. It's not the best Star Wars game, let's say, because Squadrons is my favorite, but also it's not bad. It's pretty interesting, quite heavy story-driven, but yeah, you might enjoy that one, plus, of course, Star Wars on PlayStation VR 2 with the super awesome haptics and very, very sharp resolution on this very nice 4K OLED display. Might look much better. Somebody asked me if there is lightsabers in this game, and honestly, I cannot remember if it is or not. I don't know. Can you have Star Wars game without the lightsabers? I'm not sure. So this is the PlayStation VR 2 trailer you've seen. Of course, the game was out on Quest as well. That's the platform I played it on before, but PSVR 2 definitely gonna enhance a lot of things. Now another game, this is Zenith, The Lost City. Now this is the game that I didn't have a chance to play, but I wanted to put it on here because it's getting, well, it's very popular among PSVR and VR owners in general. But also, I've been doing news on this game, of course, I know from the comment section how good it is and how much you like it. But also, just yesterday, I've done a news video when they've been talking about the expanding the team, and they actually got some people who worked on World of Warcraft in a bigger roles. So this game got potential to become something very, very special. Especially that Ramen VR, the developers of this game, saying that they're going to have some awesome updates for this game this year. And of course, the trailer you see in here, it is the PlayStation VR 2 trailer. Now, controversial a bit. Some people, that's why I didn't put it higher, let's say. I know some of you refusing to buy Moss Book 1 and 2 again. I love this game, so I definitely gonna get it on PlayStation VR 2. Just a disclaimer, this trailer is from the PlayStation VR 1 version. Sadly, we didn't saw most to footage from PSVR 2 version yet, but hopefully the developer will share it. What I'm thinking is happening here, of course, this is a game that costed a lot of money to make. There was a lot of resources to spend. It's a big team at Polyarc. Of course, Moss Book 2 released kind of when PlayStation VR 2 user base got quite smaller than what it used to be. So maybe they trying to get some money what they spend on. Plus, I'm thinking that there's gonna be a lot of PlayStation VR 2 owners who never played Moss Book 2, so the developers still gonna sell a lot of copies. I wouldn't be surprised if they sell more than on PSVR 1. This is a cool looking game, Kayak VR Mirage. This is out on PC, but the trailer is PSVR 2, I think, but I think they're using PC footage, I don't know. Basically, it's gonna look like on PC. It's gonna look like this, which is a very photorealistic look. It's not the most content-heavy game, but they swapped quantity for quality because they went for this photogrammetry, photoscanned realistic environments. Plus, there's a lot of interaction happening in those. Like you can see now, everything got like its own physics. You can see some animals, beautiful lightning effects. This game gonna have freedom. I love this stage here. That looks just so good. This game, then this is like Caribbean Sea, I suppose that is. But anyway, this game, apart from your, you know, time attack and asynchronous multiplayer, it will have as well freedom mode. Another game I didn't play, but I know from you especially that it's super awesome. I always say survival games, it's not my biggest cup of tea, but I'm still being told by you, go and play it, Paul. The game won multiple awards, Game of the Year, you know, very, very good reviews. And what they did now, they remastered it for the PlayStation VR 2 version. And what's even better news is that if you own the game already, I love this jumping. So in past it used to be teleportation, they said, now it's smooth locomotion everywhere. Even in combat you can jump around and everything. But yeah, if you own the original version of Song in the Smoke, then this version is gonna be totally free because it will release as a free upgrade. And I must say, looking great. Look how many Game of the Year awards it won. Ooh, jump in the water. Splat. Another one, Pavlov. So one of few online shooters releasing on PlayStation VR 2. Of course, we're gonna have the After the Fall as well coming. But Pavlov is something what you wanted throughout the lifespan of PlayStation VR 1. You wanted and you wanted and you wanted, and sadly it didn't happen. But the developer made it happen for PlayStation VR 2, and what's even better, as of now, the game is still confirmed as a PSVR 2 launch title. Had some cool updates, and they all making it to PSVR 2 version. As you can see here, the World War 2 update reminds me just of Medal of Honor games back in the day. Look at that, operating tank, driving vehicles. I'm not the biggest multiplayer person, and I don't really play multiplayer games. But I might just check out Pavlov. This is a zombie mode as well, so you got everything what you need from the online shooter, and you've got it in VR. It's a game you really, really wanted for a very, very long time. Right, let's move on to the another game and a big title. This is No Man's Sky Virtual Reality Version. Of course, you played it on PSVR 1. It's had PSVR 2 update, so basically it looked much sharper on PS5. I mean PSVR 2, PS5 update, that's what I meant to say. But also they're doing PSVR 2 upgrade and it's gonna look just the best. Probably very, very similar. You can see there it's on par with the flat version of the games. Of the game, this is going to be absolutely fantastic. It's a game with unlimited content, so yeah, you're definitely gonna enjoy that one if you are a No Man's Sky fans. Okay, moving on to top 3. At number 3, I decided after much big deliberations within myself, having conversation with myself, because I didn't play it yet, I don't know, I got feeling that it's gonna be great. Horizon Call of the Mountain. It might be even number 1 PlayStation VR 2 game. Of course, the idea of the game we've got is, you know, those few levels, like a 5 levels, interactive experience, super cool graphics, you know, solid game. But I wonder if we're gonna get few surprises here and there. This is might be PlayStation VR 1, VR 2 best title, but like I said, I cannot speak about it yet because I didn't play it. I know many people played the demo, but that was just very, very far. Very fall, very small slice of this game. We soon gonna have full slice and we're gonna be like, oh, no, eating it all, because it's gonna be super awesome. My PlayStation VR 2 bundle, just like many of yours bundles, comes with the Horizon Call of the Mountain. Cannot wait for this game. Combat looks great as well. Yeah, really, really cool. I mean, graphically, you know, you cannot expect more from the VR game. It's really taking it to the next level. But as you see in the another two games, you might have an idea what they are now, maybe not, I don't know. They can pull off the great graphics as well. So let's, this is the, by the way, the gameplay trailer from the game. Really, really awesome. So Fire Sprite Studio did great. Of course, you know them before from The Persistence, which was awesome game, but now they did that one. Wow, this game gonna be awesome. Here, okay, now. This top 3 was really hard to do, so let me know what is your top 10. I really struggled, but anyway. Resident Evil Village, I completed it about 3-4 times now, flat. I know some of you don't play it, I just couldn't wait, okay? I like Resident Evil games. So I wanted to play it anyway, and now it's coming, you know, to PlayStation VR 2. All game will be played in VR, all of it, there is no compromises made, and you're gonna be using your VR Sense controllers. With Resident Evil 7 you have to use your DualShock, but they change it here, you can see it. It's definitely gonna look beautiful in the headset. Look at just the footage, that's the PSVR 2 game, that's mental to think about it like that, but yeah, it's gonna be great. So it's, I decided to put it on number 2, even though I was really, like, you know what, top 3, it could be joint number one, but of course it's a list of top 10. But definitely pick up all those games if you can, because they all seem great. This is the list of the launch titles, of course. Everything beyond that, your Switchbacks, your Resident Evil 4, you know, that's the different story. Now, the one I decided to put at number one, especially after reading recent news about it, is Gran Turismo 7 Virtual Reality Mode for PlayStation VR 2. You can see it in the background from the gameplay, what the developer published. How great it looks in VR. It just takes my words away from me, this game. So all of it is playable in VR. They even added another game mode, which is the VR showroom, when you can just look around the cars, mess around with buttons and stuff like that. Of course, split screen multiplayer is not supported. Also, the game running at 120 frames per second, but it is, that's what they said to IGN, but it is achieved by running it at 60 and then reprojecting it to 120 seconds, which is another technique of, you know, what they can utilize to get maximum best performance, combined with the foveated rendering with eye tracking. That, thanks to all of that, they can achieve this level of realism in virtual reality game. And of course, this is as well, if you own Gran Turismo 7, on launch day, this is gonna become an absolutely free upgrade for your game, for you to download. Currently, Resident Evil Village is off 50% until 15th of February, so you can download it for like $19. And Gran Turismo 7 is off 37%, so you can download it for like $40, so you can get it on sale. So yeah, let me know what is your top 10. That's, for me, is top 10 must-have, must-buy titles at launch for PlayStation VR 2. But let me know what you're thinking and what is your top 10. Of course, before I go, stay tuned to the channel. As soon as I got any PlayStation VR 2 news about any games, I'll be doing video. We've had a lot of those lately, but hey, there was a lot of news. And of course, big shout out to all the patrons. You are all awesome. I super appreciate your support. And that's it. Bye.